round and sister function round up and round down. And whenever you know you have a number, and here I converted the information for our car sales report into thousands. So now you can see it right here. It has the decimal points, but you know I don't need that kind of detailed information. So many times you want to use round function to kind of round it to the next digit. So I want to round up the numbers. If I use the round function equal round, it will take the number and I can press close the parenthesis, press enter. And now what it does, because I see a zero here, it's actually rounding up to the less integer. So that's what it's doing. Now let's say I'm going to actually do absolute reference for the column, so I can copy the formula across. If I do function F4 and I just rotate through the options, I want to have a dollar sign by the column but not by the row. It's like, what kind of color is this? It's very hard to see. Let me see. Now I'm going to use magnify to make sure. Yes, that's what it is. I wish you had another option to see this formula bar in bigger, because it's very hard to see the formula. So I'm going to copy it over this way. Now, so these are, you can see, like, let me show you the decimal places. It's zero, right? Because we are rounding up just to the first integer. So if I put comma one, now it's going to round up with one decimal place at the end. So you see what's happening right there? One decimal. If I do negative one, what it will do, it's actually going to round up to the second integer. So like right now, you see the four, it's gone right there. So you have to understand what you're trying to round up and in your analysis, why you're using certain things. So I'm just going to remove it for now and just have a standard round up to the less, to the first integer, and I'm going to remove the zeros and I'm going to copy over this to the round up and round down. And why you might want to use round up or round down? Let's say round up, maybe you're calculating something, some kind of analysis, and it's counting the number of people and it doesn't make sense to have a half a person, so you want to round up things. And with rounding down, maybe it's something that you're buying certain amount of something and you don't need that maybe, you know, extra pound of something, so half a pound, so you will just round down. So you have to want to know why you're using round up and round down or round function in your analysis. So here I'm just going to double click on the function and just say round up, and here I'm going to say round down. And in our case, and actually let me just show you the decimal places, because that's interesting to see what's happening here. So now I'm just going to copy the formulas down, and you can see in some cases, like right here, because I have 1,094.5, the round and round up, it's doing the same thing, but the round down is actually just rounding up to 1,094. And you can see in some cases, you know, the most cases round and round up is the same, but the round down is where you see the difference. And you know, when you look at this, you think, oh, okay, what's a big deal? Not a big deal. You're estimating, you're rounding things. But if I show you, hold on, let me just move this a little bit here. I have some hidden calculation here. So here I just did the calculation of the difference between round up and round down, and in our case that's 14, which is 14,000. So you have to think about it, like, wow, that's, you know, when you actually put it into numbers, there is a difference between using these functions. Now if we change the decimal places, let's say we're going to do to round the function to the second integer, and in our case we're going to copy it over and do the same thing for the other functions. Okay, I have to say minus one to the second integer. and now copy it over. And now you can see that when you round up to the second integer, it's becoming 1,100,000, and this one is 1,090,000. And when you keep doing that, then here the difference between the round up and round down function, let me show you this way, it's 150,000. So you want to be careful when you're using these functions. You want to understand what you're doing in your calculations and what effect it will have on the bottom line. Thanks so much for watching.